All right, guys.
All righty.
It is day
one.
One.
First
numero
day.
Uno.
All right, we're gonna head outside. We are in Gibraltar, and this is our hotel.
And
up there is. Botanical Gardens in Gibraltar. Cool looking plants.
And I'm a big fan of that tree.
Yeah, it's a good one. We've entered our first pilgrim lodging, and just a dump, huh?
Huh. Man, this is nice. We're
so clean. I take off my shoes. So, anyway, nice place. This is an Airbnb, actually. So, weren't any pilgrim lodgings in this town. Actually, there may have been. We didn't find any. So. Yeah, I was mentioning we go through so many different kinds of gate. Had some paved roads and some cow paths and some of this stuff today.
Did you just call me a cow path?
No, I did not call you a cow path.
There's no great way to get across here.
Morning pilgrims on day number
three.
Good morning everybody. Today is day number four.
Five. Three, two, one.
Today is day number four. Okay, this is one of those moments you get to laugh about later. and not at the moment. We're having to scramble through this. The route took us through this power station, and the fences are blocked with a lot of official signs saying do not enter. And it's manned, so we just couldn't even cheat. Which means scrambling through these briars and brambles in this ditch, and it's been a struggle. Hey, Allison.
Yeah.
You made it.
Woo-hoo. I worked up a sweat. We haven't even gone a pool
yet. Yep, same here. So we're going to go this way into the deep, dark, scary tunnel. And we know that because of the yellow arrow right there. All right. So on to the deep, dark, scary tunnel. This is where it gets the name Valley of the Vultures.
Anybody got a light in it?
Got a what?
Light in it.
Light?
Yes.
Take a lamp.
Yeah.
Do you really need it?
It's
okay. So this was a fun little place to stay if you enjoy flipping power circuits on and off.
Oh, yeah. We did it a lot.
Quick video of the train we've been going through has been technically challenging. Lots of wet, slippery rocks really slowed us down today because you just have to be so careful where you put your feet. The mud has been somewhat relentless as well, as you can tell from Rodney's pants. My pants, Allison's pants, are all coated in mud. Looks like we have a valley coming up though, that'll be good. We've been up in the clouds for a good bit of the time. So we've been misted on, and I'm pretty sure I saw little bits of snow or sleet or something in the rain, which is cool and also cold. Wet. Okay. There we go. You guys are filthy.
We are.
You're just filthy people. After yesterday's simple stroll through the nicely paved and treated paths.
Simple stroll, my foot.
We decided
we've gotten lazy. I think he was on a different trip than I was.
Going up to dinner, and it's windy a little bit, misty as it's been for a couple days, and we got to climb up there where the grocery store is.
Where the restaurant is.
And the restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
Well, basically everything.
Yes.
But the good news is we can climb down. Reached a beautiful section.
We have. It's quite pretty. It's very scenic.
Yeah. We have dryness for the first time in what seems like a lot of days.
And sunshine.
That's right.
It's crazy. It doesn't actually always rain here.
That's cool.
It's cool, yeah. You are correct. It is not, we're not baking. Invited to us, so I'm
and Maria
impressed.
Was a very quiet, quiet individual.
She
talked all the time.
This
so by
guy
the time,
fabricates stuff all over the place.
Yeah. So by the time you thought you understood what she said about five sentences ago, she was off and running.
And
with
the more
else.
You understood, the faster she went.
Yes, it was like.
Yeah, it was great. Really pushed me in my conversation yesterday. And she insisted on you work on it. I don't know. I loved it.
It was great.
She wasn't going to let you get away with anything.
No. She's a fun personality.
No, that was a fun experience. No. Highly recommend Bar Pastor. I don't know. Got anything to add there, Rodney?
Not at the moment. I'm still recovering from the cold. I don't feel the effects quite as much. So I'm hopefully going to be a little bit more cheerful about my... responses. We'll see how that goes. I'm not sure.
I may just be a Debbie Downer.
I'm a Debbie Downer.
Thank you.
is day
11
out of 785,000.
Everybody, this is day number
12,
a dozen days, and I think we're reaching a dead end at the very beginning,
which is kind of funny.
We're great.
Just
it's
means
not
the rest
that
of the
unusual
day
actually
better.
For us. Yeah, there's no gate here.
And
no,
I'm
maybe.
In shorts this morning because I lost one pant leg a day or two ago, and I wasn't gonna walk around with one pant leg on and one zip off on and one off.
I'm telling you, that's Camino chic.
Oh yeah, that's stylish.
Good morning, pilgrims. It's dark outside, so I thought I'd do a real quick, day number
11?
Mm-hmm.
13.
Oh,
lucky day.
And then 13, we're off on quite a long day. That's why we're starting. It is 5:30.
Almost halfway. Hands are cold.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Very, very cold for a while.
Yep.
Good morning, pilgrims. It is
Good
day
morning.
Number
14.
2 weeks on the trail.
Wow, it's hard to believe.
You'll notice it's a slight bit lighter than it was when we left yesterday. We had a more leisurely morning because we don't have as long a day today. I must admit, what time is it?
7:26.
Okay, so an hour and a half is a bit excessive.
Yes, it is to get ready. We were lazy.
We're getting ready. But we enjoyed it.
We did. It's nice. We had coffee.
We had coffee. We had breakfast. So we've got some things checked off the list anyway.
Awesome. Yeah.
Won't be quite as nice as stopping at a truck stop at O'Dark 100 and having that warm cup of coffee freshly prepared. But
after having walked for
an hour already, we already had. At this point in time, 7:30, we probably had
eight kilometers
already done of the day. So we're going to be a bit later getting in today, I think.
No one's following me on the Camino. At least some donkeys are.
Good morning, pilgrims.
Good morning,
all.
It is day number
15.
15.
15.
We're more than two weeks into it now.
That's right.
Crazy.
And we have
still alive.
Some things are remarkable.
Apparently, still have the cough, which is crazy. But,
yes. Nadine and Ken should be in
day one, maybe.
Day one. Whether they've started walking or whether they're just transporting down, but we wish them bon camino also.
We'll be leaving the desert flat village of Aracena. It's just like boring,
this
laid
man
out.
This speaks with forked tongue.
Very late dinner last night. What do we
Fabulous
have?
Fabulous dinner.
Oh,
very
so
good. The bull, not cow, but bull, was fantastic. Really tender.
Yes. Tasty.
And yummy. The artichokes. Allison fell in love with the
artichokes. Grilled artichokes.
With ham on them, Iberian ham. Mm-hmm. And there was something else. Another, of course, cheese. cheese course.
Yeah, it wasn't so crazy about that, but that's okay. Yeah.
And dessert. And Rodney has this had this local dessert. We all had some as well. It's, think of it basically as a piece of French toast soaked in honey. I mean, absolutely marinating in honey. Yeah. And
oversaturated.
It was great.
And my blood sugar was still 120 this morning, which is incredible.
Incredible. That's what exercise will do.
Yeah.
And Rodney is leading us out of town using Gaia. So
I'm lost.
No, he's not lost.
I got a clue.
He has a clue. Allison, say something. You have the mic.
I know. I'm just enjoying the camaraderie and checking out the dark clouds, considering the forecast said no rain. And Rodney very kindly said, I loved his statement, which was, this is the first time you volunteered to
walk uphill when I didn't have to.
It was
I'm
great.
I'm telling you, he's getting into shape, man. He's loving it.
Probably another 10 weeks and I'll be there.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I think it's day
17.
That's what I was going to say.
Was it?
We did it in stereo.
And it's a short one.
Yep.
Hooray.
Just like yesterday. after Rodney finishes dying.
Yeah.
Again.
And then all of a sudden it went straight uphill, much to Rodney's dismay. But he made it. Look, and he's not coughing. He can still talk and walk. We are good.
The taxi really helped.
The taxi.
Not taking it.
Yep.
Okay, guys, it is day number
18. Sorry.
I just said that.
You did. Apologize, guys.
18. We got a long day. That's why we're starting at dark 30. 5:56 in the morning. Got up at 5 o'clock and have a long day, but it is mostly downhill. So it may not be quite as bad as we think. It's just going to be a longer day. So we have to sort of mentally prepare for that. So anyway, obviously clearly very dark outside, hence taping inside. Anybody got anything to say about the day?
It's beginning bright and early. We can only hope for positive, wonderful things.
Wow.
That sounded a bit ominous.
It is our last full day in Spain.
Oh, that's right.
It is.
And or until we come out the other side of Portugal.
We have to drop the keys off at a mail slot in a florist shop down the street.
We hope that florist shop is obvious.
We think those were the instructions. If not, somebody at a florist shop is going to get a key.
At number 31.
At number 31.
31 and florist.
Now, noting that it won't have the house number on it.
Oh, yes. No.
But it has a picture of the Madonna in tile.
Yes.
Okay. Or something like that.
Yeah. She made
or
a big deal
or Mick
that.
Jagger.
Or no. Mick Jagger. So there's something.
I haven't seen a Madonna that looks like Mick Jagger yet, but I'll keep my eyes peeled. Okay.
Looks like the mountains will have disappeared. So there you go.
We're gonna have to rope Rodney in.
All right. I'm gonna have to tie a harness to him so we can get going. Rodney's been taken off in the flatland, so.
Just so I don't slow him so much up at the hills.
Oh yeah, he keeps saying that, but it's not happening anymore. Somewhere there is the border that we'll be crossing tomorrow morning, probably in the dark. Morning, everybody. Today is day
19.
Again in the dark. Last day for a while anyway, in the dark because for a couple of reasons. Well, I don't know, honestly. We lose an hour.
Yeah, spring forward.
No, not spring forward, but we go to Portugal.
Right. Oh,
so
that's right.
It was a beautiful sunrise.
And Rodney.
And Rodney. A beautiful Rodney. A beautiful Rodney and a sunrise.
Here we are in España. And now we're in Portugal.
Yay!
We did it. We survived Spain.
It was getting through customs here was difficult.
this guy's a tough character.
Roddy's still going through customs. All right, now he's through customs. I mean, it's fun because you're hanging out with me, I know, but other than that,
I want a refund.
What's a refund? You don't get refunds on Caminos. Ugh. It's a no exchange, no return policy.
How about on brothers?
That you'll have to talk to Mom about. Mom, Rodney's trying to disown me again. Here we are, having lunch. Side of the road. What was for lunch today, dear?
Salmon in a can. With bread, not with the salmon on it.
A green pepper.
Mm-hmm. Deconstructed.
Yep. A ham and cheese flavored potato chips. And a digestive cookie, which is quite dry, but tasty. For all of you back home, this is the exciting part when we have the camera on.
to get somebody to talk to.
Besides each other.
Besides each other.
Yeah.
All right, good morning, everybody. We have no microphone. Can't seem to get it on this morning. It is day number
20.
Everybody,
good morning.
It is day number
21.
Okay, good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
It is day number
22.
Morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Today is day number
23. Whoops.
23.
Yesterday was 22.
Alrighty. Hi, folks. Hope everybody's doing well back home. You're probably a lot warmer than we are at this point.
Yeah.
Although there was some snow not that long ago back home.
So. That's true. I think this morning, I mean, in the mornings, in the evenings, it gets quite cool here. Oh, yeah. The air is dry. So I think it's about 41. This morning, but it will warm up quickly as the sun hits us.
There's no breeze today so far.
Not even water under us, there's concrete under us. Great.
So this was a natural obstacle we did not expect.
I know.
On the map, there is no lake here. It's just a river and we're supposed to cross over there.
There's a crossing there. And,
oh look, we can cross here.
And look to your left, you can also cross there. Nope, further out.
Oh yeah, there's a road. What's the fun in that though?
Oh, I could tell you lots of fun about that.
Na promedida, procissões têm um cheiro a rosmaninho. Na tasca daquela mais escondida, cheira a iscas com elas e a vinho. Fica bem uma água portada, cheira bem, cheira a Lisboa. Volta a purinha tapada, cheira bem.
Good misty morning, everybody.
Ooh, good misty morning.
We're on day number 23.
You know, I gotta mess it up for fun.
Well, there, we've created a monster.
I know, he's way up there in front. This is as close as we've been to him in at least an hour. It's like, boy. He said he was going to go ahead and walk slowly.
He lied.
Nope. Yeah. Total sprinter. Yeah. There he is.
He stopped to take some pictures. The only reason we're this close.
Yeah.
We are going at a clip of
average clip, 4.4 kilometers an hour. We're currently going, trying to, sort of just not counting the brakes, at 5.1 kilometers an hour.
Wow.
And we're not catching up.
No, we won't. So.
The tough part about this road is very easy to get off track. It's very complicated. A lot of negotiating. Always turns. See, I mean, look what's happening to Rodney already.
It's the wind.
Everybody?
Good morning.
Good morning.
It is day
25.
Look at that. Everybody physically this morning. Rodney.
My feet are okay. The blister on my left big toe is there, but I've treated it about as well as I can at this point.
Yeah.
Feet seem to be a little on the...
So we need to go that way. But it seems to be a little bit of traffic at the moment.
We're going to let them do their thing.
Because they would. Horns blowing.
Yeah. Truck coming behind them. There's just a few, and one or two definitely outweigh the three of us.
Yeah, keep on going down the road, I guess. There's some baby ones.
Yeah, they don't really like us here, but we're not threatening.
They all have numbers in their ears.
Hmm.
All right. We're walking with the sheep.
We are.
In another tourist hunting zone.
We have a picture to prove it, and I typed it in with all the appropriate accents, and it still says tourist hunting zone. So, yeah.
This may be the last recorded record of the adventures of Rodney, Mark, and Allison. So as you've seen in the vlog, we are not where we're supposed to be. We're in the town of Evora. To enter the Chapel of the Bones.
Yeah, and that was that's so that we can check all the boxes of types of transportation we have thus taken so far.
Plane,
you know,
bus,
taxi,
walking, and
ambulance.
That's why I had ferry.
Yeah.
Procurar esquecer. Ai, numas gingilhas, pois dar comer a amor é o melhor, já dizia Mariquinhas. Pois dar comer a amor é o melhor, já dizia Mariquinhas.
Bravo! Hey, everybody.
It is day 29,
and we are officially starting the Camino with no, we're going bare bones. We're not carrying any clothes. We're going to wear these the entire trip.
We had our backpacks all forwarded back to the U.S.
Yeah, we're just going to do it. We're going to go with no money, no passports, completely.
True pilgrims.
We had a hard time finding naked albergues to stay in, so we can do our laundry, though.
We'll do it one at a time. We'll share clothes.
Yes.
These guys are all on their own. I have my passport. I'll see you soon.
I have mine too.
So the picture, the picture preview to this was the very
official,
very proud of their start of the Camino. It's a yellow arrows hand spray painted on the side of the church. So anyway, here we go. We're going to do the first couple of kilometers today and then kick off tomorrow in the morning. So.
Hey.
Bye, everybody.
Bye. Adios.
Everybody, it is day number
30.
30. Let's get on a pilgrimage.
Let's move. Yeah.
Anybody want to add anything? You got to talk to Allison because she's got the microphone.
Wow. Yeah. Nadine probably is quiet as a.
What do you want to say, Nadine?
Good morning, everybody. We are on our way. The Portuguese Camino.
Where are we going today?
I have no idea.
Oh, a smidge heavier than before. We stopped at a grocery store and bought two breakfasts and two lunches for five people.
pilgrims.
Good morning.
Today is day number
31.
Where are we going today?
That way.
North.
All of those are true. Will they remember the town?
Maybe it starts with an A.
A-L something.
No.
No, that was this town.
It begins with a G.
You made the reservation.
I know.
It begins with a C. It
begins with a C-O-R-R, something like that.
It looks like Corrigado.
Corrigado.
Good morning.
Today,
32.
Halfway in the number of days for us on the whole trip, leaving the sweltering, in this sweltering morning. As you can all tell, we're dressed for
9 degrees Celsius.
9 degrees Celsius?
Yes. It was at 7.
That's pretty cool. Nice sunrise this morning. We're off to the town of... Come on, guys. You can do this.
It's early on, people. I have an excuse.
Okay, we're leaving the town of... Oh, come on!
Karagoga.
Karagata.
Karagata.
And we're going to the town of Vallada. You guys are really bad. You literally have no idea where you are.
Nope.
All right, good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Today is day number 33. Who's this pilgrim?
Sylvie.
From
France.
We met her yesterday. We're going today from?
Vallada. To
Santarem.
Santarem. All right, the ladies got it. Gentlemen, you're slacking on me here. Pilgrims.
Good morning, everybody.
Can we stop for a second? That's pretty.
That's beautiful. Yeah.
That's where we're going. Okay.
More flat. Oh,
okay. Yeah, it is great. Okay, today is day number
34.
And we're going from
Santarem.
Santarem to
Azengada.
Azengada. All right, you're on the ball now. Tip a rocket.
I had my little cheat sheet pulled up.
She was getting ready.
We haven't talked to it ever. Allison's got the mic on. So. Walking out of the city of Santarem, we walked through the city walls, through the gate of Santiago. So it's fun to think of that gate, for however long that wall's been there, and that gate's been there, centuries. that pilgrims have been walking through that same gate, down this same cobblestone path, on the way to Santiago. So this town that we were in was voted as the most Portuguese town in Portugal in 1937. Why that is of interest in the Wikipedia, I'm not really sure, but it's also home of a famous poet who we've never heard of, right, Ken?
Yes.
Like, big statues.
I heard of his name in Portuguese from a Portuguese person, and couldn't remember how to say it like 10 seconds later. I did say it right after he said it, though.
Well, there's a statue of him. There's quotes of his poems on plaques everywhere. There's a foundation named after him in town.
He won a Nobel Peace Prize.
He did.
Oh, he won a Nobel Prize?
Yes, he did. He won something in on Portuguese, and then he also, like a few years later, won a Nobel Peace Prize. So, famous guy, their claim to fame.
Climb today in the first half of the walk.
Ooh, doggy.
So we haven't done climbing in a bit.
No, we're going to wake up some muscles and they're not going to be real joyful about it at first.
Well, we've been up for, Alice and I've been up for a while because outside our room was a rooster that thought that 2:30 a.m. was the appropriate time to wake up.
Oh, goody. Look, a hill. How does everybody feel about this hill?
I'd rather not think about it.
At sea level. Look, sea level. Muck level. Yeah.
I don't see it as being level.
Ken was all excited about the fact that it was relatively flat. We weren't going up a steep trail just to our right. And then we round this bend. And lo and behold, they were hiding it from us. Yeah. Good morning.
It's day number
38.
And it's day
Easter.
Easter. He's risen. He's risen indeed.
The mantra. So I think we'll go to everybody's house to party last night and sing.
Oh, that would be awesome.
So today we're going from
Tomar to they got it right. Look,
you guys are on fire. That was a fun time. Now you'll notice that there's one less of us.
Yeah,
Did we leave Ken?
We lost a body.
No, Ken left us. He's left us this morning.
That's
Ken,
true.
Ken has a heart different.
Pilgrim.
Hey, we're not really pilgrims. We went on vacation in the island somewhere.
You feel like a pilgrim, dear?
Not really. No. My body aches like one, but right now it's fantastic.
But it's, yeah, it's a sort of a ranch type of place.
It's pretty horses over there.
Yeah, got horses, got a pool. And you might want to ask, well, where's Rodney? Well, he's napping.
Napping. 10.
Good morning. It's still morning.
Good morning. I know it's 10 o'clock in the morning. Crazy.
Yeah. It's day
39. Day 39.
I thought everybody had their cheat sheets out looking real quick.
39.
All right. And we're going to Alvorgue.
Alvorgue from Cortica.
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 Had a little twiddly thing under the sea.
And this is our hardest day.
Yeah, this is number one on the Naismith scale, hardest length and elevation. We've got most of the elevation. Well,
we
the hardest hill done.
Yeah, yeah. It was early, which was, yeah.
And we come across this cool little path.
Yeah, with several.
By stone walls.
With several going off that aren't quite as attended.
I came here yesterday. I can't tell you how hard it was to put this up for you guys. I mean, after you guys went to sleep, I came out here. Getting them all covered with moss to make it authentic,
oh, yeah.
That was a labor of love.
Thank you. We appreciate the effort, dear.
What I found humorous is that we'll be going along the path. The walls are this high on both sides, and there's a Camino thing with an arrow pointing straight ahead. It's like, where else could
where
I go?
Go?
Well, you know, believe it or not, there's somebody that probably got lost here.
Thank you. Morning, buddies.
Good morning. Good morning.
Today's day number
40.
40 years lost in the wilderness.
We've been wandering for 40 days and 40 nights. We're leaving the town of Alvor. But when it went away.
Good.
It was a good night's sleep.
Yay.
It was very quiet in that room, other than the banging of doors.
Yeah, it was.
Snoring.
Oh, and a little snoring.
Who was the snore? Me?
Probably me, too.
I didn't know it was me. I could hear somebody else.
Yeah. I could hear some snoring, too, at times. So. We had just had a wonderful breakfast.
Oh,
yes.
It was so good. What did we have?
We had cheese
local cheese
and a pastry.
Well, some of us did.
See, that's like, he doesn't look right.
He's praying, the praying sheep.
I said it was a yoga pose. Numbered facing sheep.
Numbered facing sheep, I love it. That's a new one. We'll have to figure that one out.
You have to have a woolly butt to do it.
Our conversations have obviously disintegrated here.
Just that pose to her next.
Yes. Cindy, there's a new yoga pose for you to introduce to your class. The downward facing sheep with a woolly butt.
And there's the sun.
Morning, pilgrims.
Good morning.
This is day number
41.
We are going from
here to there.
Coimbra. So we will meet up with Ken.
At the monastery.
It is.
He's become a monk.
It is pouring down rain.
Well, it was supposed to be.
Yeah. We had breakfast before we left today,
that's
which was
an
a little
thing.
Different.
Yeah. Now, Nadine treated us to some scrambled eggs and cheese.
Oh, they were delicious.
And, anyway. Oh, I was Holy mentioning tea. We said goodbye to Frances, and she got a bracelet. We had a real good talk last night. That was funny. Remember to focus on Nadine right at that spot.
Nice and private. The only glitch is they have a few leaky problems in their bathroom, but
yeah.
Besides that.
And another place where you had to stuff toilet paper in a trash can instead of down the drain.
Yeah. That wasn't quite obvious to me until you went to flush and then nothing happened.
There's a big old sign on the back bathroom door.
Yeah, I didn't look at that.
Pay no
it
attention.
It wasn't in English, it was just symbology. It wasn't all that clear. It could have been.
I was thinking it was no trash, toilet paper.
Yeah.
Because a lot of times it's that.
Yeah.
Don't throw square blocks in the
trash.
See?
No brushes and combs down the toilet.
That's okay.
We had a real good talk last night about faith issues and stuff, so I thought that was enjoyable and appreciated, and she was receptive, so it's like, well, yeah. Alrighty, folks, we'll see how the day goes. Maybe we'll beat the rain. Maybe the rain will beat upon us. Either way, we've got rain gear. We are ready.
We're ready. We're all tucked in.
Yep. All right, bye, team.
Bye.
Bon Camino.
Bon Camino.
Morning, pilgrims.
Good morning.
We are leaving the gorgeous town of Coimbra and heading to
Minhada.
Minhada.
Which
on day number 42.
Yeah, which we lovingly want to refer to as Meathead because that's
meathead.
Easier to say.
That's right, Meathead.
We're not going to Meathead, we're going to
Milada.
We're up on a steep hill, the monastery behind us.
It's very pretty with the sun behind it.
So Ken is going to make his way somewhere, maybe Porto, maybe somewhere else. He hadn't decided. He's not going to join us. His pilgrimage walk is over.
Yeah.
Hip's still hurting him. That's a shame, but better than obviously injuring it further.
Yes. Yeah. Smart decision. Hate to see him have to give it up totally, but he's going to as Mark said, train or bus ahead, depending what he feels like. Hello.
One of the things I love most about walking Camino is being completely out in the country, away from
cars,
all of civilization.
Oh yeah. Yep. At least there's a shoulder for us to walk on. We're probably also supposed to share it with cyclists, but it's a shoulder that's paved. No, we haven't, but I don't know that we've ever seen a shoulder this wide on a country road either.
Well, it's been a while. Yeah. Even have little barriers. They're occasionally knocked down from cars swerving to hit pilgrims.
We're pretty sure that's what it is. That or they drive here at night and they can't see because there's only one line.
And they're black.
Oh, yeah. And no street lights, so you know that these posts get taken out periodically.
Morning, pilgrims.
Good morning. Number 43.
Let's try that again. It's day number
43. I feel a little salty this morning.
With a fun suckling, roasted, whole roasted suckling pig last night. We had the advantage last night of when we reserved ahead. When we got there, they put us, because it was four together, they put us in kind of a little separate quarters.
Yeah.
We have to sleep with the riffraff.
Well, I did.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's right.
Are the riffraff doesn't have to sleep with us. It's like, yeah.
So I want it fully documented, though. I, last night, woke up with all three of these guys snoring. And then I dozed off and woke myself up snoring. So.
Oh, that's funny.
Sunrise this morning.
That is pretty.
Today is day 44.
Wow.
And we're going to something something ANOVA.
Yes.
From
something something ANOVA.
The town we're in now.
From here. Let's see. Is that a street name?
No. I've completely forgotten at the moment.
But it's
all right.
You
want to climb those steps, Roddy?
Oh, yeah. He's looking forward to it. I could tell.
All right. We finally get some hills today.
Yes.
And sunshine.
Hills and sunshine.
It's going to be a better day than mopey yesterday.
Yes.
Everything was mopey yesterday. The weather.
We all felt a little depressed. It was like, okay, good, check. That day is over.
Grumpy people.
Yes.
Hey guys, what you doing?
Having lunch at a eucalyptus globule.
Because doesn't everybody? It's on everybody's bucket list. Yeah.
Always wanted to have lunch in a eucalyptus globule. Now Mark, I can. Now I can say I've done it.
Mark was thinking we were probably the first one to have ever eaten here. Then I found a Burger King wrapper.
He did not.
I was fibbing.
Yeah, this is what we do. We had some. Alice and I had a can of tuna fish. We thought it was going to be tuna fish, but it's actually cream of tuna fish. Even better.
Yeah, it works.
Actually, it was better. Easier to eat out on a sandwich anyway.
Yeah, there was no oil, no water to drain.
We had some leftover potato chips from last night's
chicken dish.
Coating of chicken. We had some leftover Bevita chocolate cookies. I mean, this is basically a 5-star.
Oh, yeah, obviously. We'll give it some good ratings.
I mean, the staff was really, really friendly.
The staff was friendly.
I would bring you the chocolate cookies over, but she's off.
Yeah. I'm not moving either, you notice. Yeah.
You can toss them.
Thank you, Rodney. I think the bag is all torn down the side.
We gotta finish the cookies.
Thank you.
Everybody eat 17 cookies.
17. Oh my
god. 17 each.
That's all.
The sad thing is, I probably do it, but.
Oh yeah. The chocolate is a little melty.
Chocolate's melty.
Oh boy.
We need to finish.
Alrighty, that's our picnic lunch. This is day 44. And we are still alive. Signing out.
Ciao.
That's okay.
Take two. Good morning.
Today is day number
45.
And we're going from
Paolo's house.
At Casa Coletti.
Casa Coletti. So Catholic. Casa Coletti. Coletti. And what a grump, huh?
Oh, man. She was the best grump.
Yeah. We stayed in some nice places, but I think this one is by far, he takes hospitality to a whole nother level.
Indeed a servant.
Yes.
Servant's heart.
So, we stayed in Casa Cattolica, or something like that. It was Donativo, in the town of Braca. We're very close. That's the closest village of Braca.
Braca.
And today we are going to
Saint Joe.
Saint Joa.
We're not going to Saint. We are Saint going Joe. To Saint.
Some
Joe.
Of us are.
And we're going to drop Nadine off at a train station.
We're getting rid of her. Just kidding.
Jumping her.
I mean,
the groceries have gotten too heavy.
I'm surprised the brothers didn't jump in on that one. But yeah.
Crazy to think about.
Carmen's on the way, Rodney?
Not yet, no.
Later today.
Yeah, okay.
Which for us will be late today.
Yeah.
And then she'll arrive tomorrow morning.
Woohoo!
Yeah. Crazy.
And Rodney Michael.
And Rodney Michael.
Oh, that's right.
Fun.
Rodney's kind of dreading it, and he's not really sure if he wants to see Carmen or not.
Liar.
I exaggerate for effect.
Yes, I know.
He's been counting down the days.
He has.
He's like a little schoolboy.
I know. We almost made a paper chain for him.
Oh, that would have been so fun. Not in the rain.
But can you blame him, right?
Right, yeah.
It'll be fun to have Carmen with us in Porto, and we'll see fun stuff and eat good food.
Oh, yes.
And Rodney Michael, but only for a day, which I think is crazy, Rodney Michael.
We're not going to eat Rodney Michael. No,
sure. Even for a day.
Even for a day.
Oh, man.
We couldn't even handle a half a pig. So
right. Yeah. You wake up with a whole different attitude after staying at Paolo's place.
But high today, I think, is maybe around 80. But the sun, again, is pretty intense.
And you're out in it all day.
Yeah, there's your hat is your shade and your clothes. Yep.
Rodney's been racing ahead all day. Hard to keep up with him.
Not true. But he does have a tendency when he gets tired at the end of the day to take off. So he was asking for where the hotel was. His map hadn't uploaded, and we were a little afraid to give it to him. he'll take off. He does wait after a couple hours, but yeah, we're like, I think he's ahead. We're not really sure. I know he's not behind.
Hello. Good morning, dear.
Good morning.
You're doing something on your phone?
I know. Usually it's you doing something on your phone. Turn around.
It is day number
46.
And Rodney, Ken, and Nadine, what do you guys think?
Wait a minute, where are they at? Oh yeah, we're down some
down
more.
Two.
The numbers are dropping.
Just Allison and Rodney this morning.
Rodney's still back at the lodging.
Yeah.
He's going to head out later today to the airport to meet Carmen and Rodney Michael.
Bobby will also be making his way to Valenza. That's where we're going to meet up. So next morning update, we'll have another person joining us. And the original three will be back together. It'll be fun. And it is either 4 or 5 days normally from Valenza. We're making it 6. We're going to
take our time.
The last little bit of this excursion.
We're going to wind down slowly.
It's the journey, not the destination. So. Alrighty, I think that's it for this morning.
I believe so, since this is a nice little farm track path that I don't think any farm equipment can roll down, but we may be shocked and surprised.
But somebody built these walls.
Yeah, moss-covered stone. It's quite pretty at the moment.
Yeah, gorgeous. I mean, this section here is pretty. It's been done a long time ago.
Yes.
All right, bye folks.
Bye.
Well, I've enjoyed Portugal. I thought the people were very friendly. They spoke a lot better English, which isn't a big deal, but certainly helped. Portuguese is fewer people know Portuguese than Spanish. Good time. There were certainly a lot of events, a lot of things that happened, joining up with Nadine and Ken, and then Ken having to drop out, and then Nadine going on her own, and Rodney going to an ambulance and go to the hospital, and then Rodney visiting with Carmen when she came, and us moving in on our own. So yeah, it's quite a an eventful stay in Portugal. I prefer Portuguese wine to Spanish wine. I know that's heresy as soon as we cross the other end of this bridge, but it's fact. Good morning, Pilgrim.
Good morning.
Today is day number
54.
54. A deck of cards and 2 jokers. You guys are the jokers.
No,
that's apparently the church.
Okay.
And apparently last night, Roger, you may have there. If you were climbing the steps, it was a group of school children. They clapped for you when you got to the top.
They did not clap for me that I recall. But
did you get to the top of the steps of the, of the church? Oh, you did, because you had to get your credential.
Yes, I came up through a schoolyard, but they didn't clap.
Huh, interesting.
They were busy and doing what they needed to do in school.
Yeah.
There's an interesting statue up here of 3 wild horses.
Huh.
I check out a picture of last night. It's maybe further back than we want to go, but it's before we enter this park. Pretty nice park.
Yeah.
And I love the way the trees have been trimmed, and yet they've still come back. If I tried to do that with anything in mind, it would just be like, okay, it's dead now.
Done now. But I died.
These sycamores, I think, have come back.
Chopped back severely, haven't they?
Yes.
A wonderful stay in the convent last night, I thought.
Yes.
With a great pilgrim's dinner, although it was almost entirely in German.
Which was hilarious.
It was three Americans.
We're in Spain, just a few footsteps away from Portugal. So.
And we had dinner with 10 other Germans. That was kind of funny. Or 9 other Germans. That was somewhat of a remarkable coincidence that we... but as we joked in our first Camino, Germans travel in packs. They start into separately, but they always gather together. So, anyway,
we are coming up to the place where the wild horses are.
Wild horse statue. Cool.
But it's up those steps.
Well, welcome back to Pilgrimage, Rodney.
Yeah.
I am glad to be back.
Yeah. Sort of
Sort of, yes. And had a splendid time with my wife and son. But it was time to go and press on.
Yeah.
And
it's almost done anyway.
Yes. Yeah. Less than 2 weeks.
Less than a week. Well, till we get to Santiago.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's like 10 days or something before I get home.
Fly home, yeah. It's 6 days to Santiago now, which is pretty crazy. And you could do it in four if you pressed, five if you pry pretty easily. And we're going to, I assume, go even slower. Or maybe we just decide to keep walking and we get there a day early. Not sure what we'd do with the extra day, but
we decided about Finisterre or not.
No. Well, Fisterra. But no. It's going to be a. Oh yeah. There's your ponies. They're nice.
I love their colorful benches.
Hi. Very nice. I love this van over here.
It is done up.
All right, that's enough for today.
Good morning.
That was fun. Good morning. I'll do it a third time. Today's day 55.
Yeah. Like the speed limit. In some places.
Over the years, the Camino has changed its route over and over again for all sorts of reasons. A new bridge gets built, a bridge gets flooded, or someone puts an interstate right in the middle of it. So that looks like what's happening here. They're building some major roadworks of some sort, right? And they've cut through the mountain, and it looks like they're going to provision for pilgrims on that bridge. Not yet ready, so we're coming down here to the interstate. But the path always changes. They say the Camino is alive that way. It's always moving around. One reason. It was kind of funny.
It was rather hilarious.
And we had some 4 a.m. people getting ready to leave. I guess they're going to try to make it all the way to Santiago, is my guess.
I guess. I swear somebody came in at like 1 a.m.
They did, because they came and were over top of
you, right?
Rodney's bunk.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
I didn't know if it was somebody who just moved.
Or you.
whatever it was.
Yeah. There was a lot of loud banging and clanking.
Straight head support,
something
though.
Something dropped out of his bunk and nearly hit my head.
Well, several times. It wasn't just once.
Right.
It was like, man, stick that thing under your pillow, in your pocket. I don't care what you don't have. I mean, three times. A little too much here, people.
And somebody left their alarm on when we went to the bathroom.
Oh, that's
that
fantastic.
Was me. I had turned the switch to off, but apparently it was the second step that they didn't do.
Carol? Yes. All right. I think that's it for today. This is the next to the last day of our pilgrimage.
Wow.
And possibly the last night of a stay in an albergue. I'm going to miss them.
I can't say that. We're all kind of like, woohoo, yippee, yahoo.
Albergue accommodations are exactly what you get for 12 euros a night.
Well, and they vary greatly.
They do.
Really do.
Massively.
I mean, I'll have to say, even though the night before was an albergue, it really wasn't bad, even though it was kind of, you know, like railroad car box style.
Right.
It gave you the illusion of privacy, and it did a decent job, where this place didn't even try.
Morning, pilgrims.
Good morning.
It's day number
58.
It's also day number
last
day. Today we go to Santiago. Our first clear view of Santiago and the cathedral in the background. I'm sure this camera won't pick it up, but yay!
Hey, but we're recording it for posterity's sake.
For posterity's sake. All right, everybody. We're in Santiago. Allison, what do you think?
Ooh,
we're back.
Again, I recognize the street.
We went shopping on this street.
We went shopping, but up and down the street.
You see the tip of the cathedral up there?
Yes. We all took our pictures from afar. Yes.
It's been a journey, folks.
An adventure.
Yeah. All we have to do is turn around and go back.
Yeah.
I think I'm going to take a different route.
We always say the medieval pilgrims, when they got to Santiago, they were only halfway.
That's right. They had to turn around and go home.
They would stay here for a few months and then turn around and head home.
Yeah. I wonder how they'd be pretty costly because of the switch.
They would stay in hostels and they would beg. So coming in from the other side this time.
It is weird. This way doesn't seem really as steep.
No.
I don't know, coming up that hill to get here.
That was a nice gradual, but it's down the other way. Yeah. I didn't appreciate it. Yeah.
Okay, Roddy, this is it. This is the plaza. Sorry? Okay, walking together.
Together in.
Started in Gibraltar, headed in Santiago.
Santiago today.
Santiago de Compostela, right in the center of the star. That's the Parador, the fancy hotel. Don't look at your cathedral. Don't look at the cathedral yet. How do you feel?
Relieved.
We did it.
Are you glad it's over?
I'm not glad it's over.
I'm just teasing.
But I'm glad we made it.
Glad we made it.
I don't think there's much doubt about you guys making it, but some of the rest of us. I mean, this part of the trio.
Now you can look at the cathedral.
All right.
It looks so much cooler without all the scaffolding.
You don't think there's too many about
that? Sunday, I'll get a Culver Stout.
They must have popular.
Pretty cool.
Yeah. Bye.
Thank you, God.
Amen.
For getting us here.
So we made it to Finisterre. Or Finisterre, depending if you're Spanish or Galician.
Down there. Yeah. Looks like a place. Looks like a toy. Right?
A toy boat.
Toy boat.
The end of the earth. We've come to the end of the earth a second time, Allison. This is the 0 kilometer point. The other 0 kilometer point.
But people started Santiago and come here as opposed
yes,
to the other
way. Yes, it's the only Camino that goes away from Santiago.
Hi.
Hello again.
You have here the Zero Marker,
Zero.
The lighthouse, and it's a straight line this way. You have a stairway, go down, you have the Iron Boot, and the Cross of the Pilgrims.
Thank you.
See you later.
In 2014, we did the Camino Fiesta.
So you know Finisterre.
We did, but my brother not.
Okay, perfect. So you can show him.
Show him everything.
Yes. Thank you.